The candles are just stacked there because fire hazards prevent me from actually lighting them. So, speech time. Living life in skin not my own, forever uncomfortable in my own flesh and bone. Living life in something truly not mine, representing an image of imperfection. The mind raped, the harsh words spread, because I don't look the image that appears in my head, in my dreams. Can you not hear those screams? I'm crying out a mere whisper, what I thought was a shout. Trapped in this flesh, a body unblessed, in parts not my own, the anatomy all wrong. My whole framework messed up in some way. Day to day I pray that one day I will be me. That's the day I will be free. Tonight we come together for Trans Day of Remembrance. We come to mourn those we have lost, and we come together as a community to remind others that they are loved and not alone in the struggle towards gender equality. I chose this poem to start the speech because it shows on some level what trans individuals feel on a day-to-day basis. Often they feel trapped and distorted to the point where they can't function. This, along with society's scrutiny of the transgender community, leaves individuals at a risk for mental distress. 41% of transgender non-conforming individuals have attempted suicide. This information was gathered by the U.S. National Transgender Discrimination Survey. According to various other sources, even though social acceptance for transgender people is growing, parents continue to abandon youth with gender identity issues when their children need them the most. Because of this, transgender youth account for 18% of homeless people in cities such as Chicago. Also, transgender youth whose parents pressure them to conform to their anatomical gender report higher levels of depression, illegal drug use, unsafe sex, and suicide attempts than peers who receive support from their parents. And 1 in 12 transgender people in America is murdered. The majority of trans women murdered in 2015 were Black or Latina, and in October, this number was at a staggering 20 victims of transgender murders. And finally, 1 in 4 transgender individuals experience violence. What can we do to stop transgender violence? We can provide emotional support for those who are victims of violence or those who are suffering from discrimination. We can provide places to stay and sleep if folks don't have a place to live. And we can provide a safe and accepting community. We can speak up about the discrimination that exists and support those who complain of being disrespected. Be respectful and show them that you care. As a community, programs can be created to educate surrounding communities and support transgender people who have lost their jobs and provide educational opportunities, housing, and job training so they can support themselves. In conclusion to this, we need to be there for each other and hope for a better tomorrow for everyone. Also, in light of recent events, Keweenaw Pride, CDI, and the Michigan Tech community as a whole send our condolences to the family and friends of Mackenzie Murtimaki, who committed suicide this past weekend in Calumet. They hope that their death would help raise awareness of transgender and non-binary issues. I would like to honor this individual and deeply mourn their loss. And with that, I will end the speech quoting some of their last words. Positive thinking is one of the most powerful forces for personal growth. Kindness is powerful. Fear almost always only holds you back. Love is beautiful and life is beautiful. Thank you for coming out supporting Michigan Tech's 2015 Trans Day of Remembrance.